Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Explanation. So in this video tutorial I'll be discussing about C programming important questions discussion part 2. Okay, so this is our part 2. Part 1 has already been uploaded in my YouTube channel. So these questions are theory question and they are important for university exams. Okay, so these are some of the most VVI questions. And I have also mentioned the marks, like for how much sentences or answers you have to write. Fine, so we'll be discussing it in depth. So first question is, what is programming language and what is the difference between source code and object code? So as you can see, it has been asked for two marks. Okay, so for 2 marks you just need to write the definition. Okay, there is no need to elaborate that. So what is programming language? So programming language is a computer language that programmers use to develop any software. So any language that a programmer is using to develop any software, some scripts, some programs, so that is called programming language. Okay, or other sets of instructions for computers to execute. Okay, so any language that is given to computer to solve a particular problem that is used by a programmer, so that is called programming language. Coming to next part, what is the difference between source code and object code? So you can see that source code is something that is written by us, by programmer. Okay, so it can be high level language or assembly level language. But object code, as you can see, the object code is executed after the compiler compiles the code. Okay, so object code is generated when a compiler compiles the code, so it is written in machine language. Fine, so source code is very close to human being, so it is easy to understand by us. But object code, as it is written in machine language, so it is difficult to understand. Source code, it is easy to modify, but object code is very difficult to modify. Source code, it contains fewer statements than object code. Object code, it contains more statements than source code. Okay, so I think for 2 marks, 4 differences are enough. Going to next part, what is identifier? What are the ways to give value to variables? Explain with example. Okay, so what is identifier? This is for 1 marks. What are the ways to give the values to variables? This is for 2 marks. And explain with example, this is for 1 marks. So going to first part, what is identifier? So identifier represents a name. Okay, so the name that is giving to variable is called identifier. For example, variables, functions, arrays, structures, unions, labels, so whatever name you give, okay, like for example, int sum, so sum is an identifier. Suppose you defined any function name, add, so add is an identifier. So an identifier can be composed of letters such as uppercase, lowercase, underscore, digit, okay, but the starting letter should be either alphabet or underscore. So you know the rule, these are the rule for defining an identifier. So it can consist of alphabets, lowercase, uppercase, underscore, digits, but it should always start with either an alphabet or an underscore. Going to second part, what are the ways to give values to variables? So here we have, whenever we declare a variable in C, okay, so what we do, we assign a value to those variables using assignment operator. Okay, so you can either declare a variable and later assign a value, for example int a, and later we will ask a value from keyboard, or we can assign the value right away, for example int a equals to 10 on the spot only. So assignment operator are used to assign the value to variable. Okay, so the left side of operand of the assignment operator is a variable and the right side of the operand of the assignment operator is a value. Okay, so it means like this. So for example int a equals to 10, so this is our variable. Okay, this is our variable and this is our value, 10 is our value, and this equals to is our assignment operator. Fine, so you can show a simple example. Okay, so it has included stdio.h, void man, so int a equals to 21 and c, so c equals to a. So what is happening here, we are assigning the value of a, that is 21, to c. Finally, we'll print this. So this is an example of assigning value. Okay, so as it has been asked for 2 marks, so 2 marks for this part and 1 marks for our program. Fine. Next, going to third part. So it is write a C program to display all characters between a given range. So this is for 6 mark. Fine. So I'll be executing this code and so. So I have written this code here. Okay, so I'll be executing this code in Dev C++. So you can see this is my code. Okay, so we have studio dot s. So main function. This is my range. Okay, so this is my minimum range. This is my maximum range. So I'll take these values from keyboard. So here I have asked enter the range from 0 to 255. Okay, so /n4 new line. So printf enter minimum range. Okay, so this n1 will give me the minimum range. Enter maximum range. So n2 will give my maximum range. And to print all the characters in range from %2 to %d, that is means n1 to nd, what we'll do, we are doing a looping. Okay, so we'll use for loop. So I equals to n1, that is it will start from n1, I will go till it is less than equals to n2 and ++i. Fine. So after that we'll print the value of i, so which is a character. Okay, so /t is for just a tab, okay, spacing. So if we'll give a value 0 to 5, so what will happen? It will be 0 here, it will be 5 here. So it will go 0, 0 is less than 5, yes. So it will go here, it will print the value of character, that is for 0. It will print the character that stands for the ASCII value 0. Again, it will go and increase the value of i to 1. Again, the loop will move like that and it will print all the values. Fine. So let's go and see the output. So here it is. Enter the minimum range. Okay, so I am giving 0. Enter the maximum range. So I am giving, suppose, 97. Okay, so as you can see, all the characters are printed here. Only the characters, okay, the numbers value are not printed here. Fine. So this is, I think this is the answer. Okay, so next, going to next question, that is question number 4. What do we mean by selective and repetitive statements? Why do we need a break and continue statement? Okay. So what is selective statement? Okay, so selection, it is like we have to check for condition. Okay, we test for a condition, like if a is greater than 2, then do this selection. Okay, like if a mod 2 equals to 0, then print even, else print odd. Okay, so we are selecting between two, either true or false. So that is called selection statement. So you can see here, selection statements allow a program to test several conditions and execute instruction based on which condition is true. Okay, so I told you, if it is true, so do this. If it is false, do that. So that is why selection statements are also referred to as conditional statement. Okay, so you know what are conditional statement: if else, else if, ladder. Next, going to repetitive statement. So repetitive statement is a statement that allow you to execute a particular statement multiple times. Okay, for example, printing a hello world 10 times. So what you will do? You will use a for loop from I equals to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. Inside that you will print hello world. So that is called repetitive, doing the same work multiple times. So there are several kinds of repetitive statement and they differ on how they determine the number of times their include statements are executed. Okay, so you can see example are for, while, do while. So going to second part. What was the second part? Why do we need break and continue statement? Okay, so break and continue statement. So what does they do? The statement continue and break may be used within loop to alter the control flow. Okay, so you know that break statement, it will terminate the loop, and continue statement, it will skip the contained iteration of the loop. Fine. So the break statement is used to terminate the loop immediately, and the continue statement is used to skip the current iteration of the loop. Okay, so I'll explain this by an example. So for example, there is a for loop for I equals to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, and if I equals to 5, then break and print hello world. Okay, so what it will do? Okay, let's iterate. Okay, so let's see what will be the output. So for I equals to 0, okay, so 0 less than 10, yes, it is true, so it is go to its body. So 0 equals to 5, no, so this break will not be executed. So let's just put a bracket here. Okay, so after that it will print hello. Fine. So again the loop will continue. So it will go here, the I value of I is 1 less than 10, yes, 1 equals to 5, no. So like this it will go up to 5. Okay, so I equals to 5, 5 less than 10, yes, it will come. So I equals to 5, yes, it is true. So it will go in the body, it will break this. Okay, so when this break statement is encountered, so what it will do, it will terminate the loop. Okay, so the program is, this program has been ended because the it will come out of this loop only. Fine. So this hello is printed only 0 1 2 3 4, it means 5 times only. Fine. Coming to continuous statement, what happens is, okay, coming to continuous statement, what happens is, for I equals to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, so when it will encounter the value 6, that when I equals to 6, it will continue. Continue means it will skip this print hello only for that particular iteration. Okay, so when the value of I will be equal to 6, it will not print hello, it will skip this statement, else it will print hello. Okay, so till I equals to 5, it will print hello. So when I equals to 6, what it will do, it will skip this statement, again it will go to loop. So now for I equals to 7, again it will print hello. Fine, so continuous statement, what it will do, it will just skip that part only for once for this particular condition. Fine. Going to question number 5, what is difference between while and do while loop? Write a program to find whether a year is leap or not. So this is very important question. Okay, this both are very important questions. So it is for 3 marks and program is for 7 marks. Okay, so you can see here while and do while loop, what is this? Okay, so this one I have taken a screenshot from my word. So this, there is a gap. Okay, so in while loop, what happens is, condition is checked first and then the statement is executed. Okay, so you might have known while I equals to 0, so first of all the condition is checked. Okay, in this, first of all the statement is executed and then only after that condition is checked. So do, okay, body, and after that there is a while. So there is no semicolon at the end of the while. Okay, so like this while condition, but there is a semicolon at the end of while. So while condition and semicolon, because it is a terminating statement. Okay, so it might occur a statement is executed 0 times if the condition is false. So if the condition is false here only, so a statement will not be executed. But in do while, once the statement is executed, either the while condition is true or false. So while is called entry control loop and do while is called exit control loop. Okay, so there might be a question, what are the difference between entry control loop and exit control loop? So don't get confused. Entry means while, exit means do while. Going to second part, to what is a leap year? Okay, so first of all let's understand what is a leap year. So any year that is divisible by 4, okay, divisible by 4 except for century years. Okay, so it is divisible by 4, so if it is divisible by 4, it is a leap year. But if it is divisible by 4 as well as it is divisible by 100, so it must be divisible by 400 also. Okay, so this means that the year 2000 was a leap year. Okay, 1900 was not, and 2020, 2024, 2028 all are leap years. So first of all let's understand this concept. Okay, so see here, if year is divisible by 4, so it is a leap year, otherwise it is not leap year. Okay, so if it is divisible by 4 and if it is divisible by 100, okay, so it must be divisible by 400 also. This is the condition. Otherwise if it is not divisible by 100, then it's okay, it is leap year only. But if it is divisible by 100, then it must be divisible by 400, then only it will be leap year, else it will not be leap year. So I think you got the condition. So once again, if it is divisible by 4, it is a leap year. Okay, else it is not leap year. If it is divisible by 100, then it should be divisible by 400 also, then only it will be leap year, else it is not leap year. Okay, also finally for 400 also it is not leap year. Okay, so this program I have done here, so I'll be executing in my Dev C++ and show you. So this is my program for leap year. Okay, so you can see here, as told in the condition, so I'll be entering a year. Okay, I'll read that. So first is, if year mode 4 equals to 0, okay, so it goes to 100. If year mode 100 equals to 0, it goes to 400. So if year mode 400 equals to 0, so if all these three are true, then it is leap year. Okay, so if all these three are true, it is a leap year, else it is not a leap year. Okay, this was the first condition. Then we have, if year mode 4 equals to 0, this one is done, this condition is done, not going to 101. Okay, so Y mode 100. So if Y mode 100 equals to 0, it is true, then what will happen? It will go to the body, next body, that is Y mode 400, else it will print, it is leap year. Fine, again going to Y mode 4, so if it is true, it will go to Y mode 100, else it will print it is not leap year. Fine. So this is the program according to the algorithm that we discussed, or we can see the diagram that we discussed previously. Fine. So it is based on if else conditions. Okay. So let's execute this. So if it enter year 2020, so it should be leap year. Okay. So again, if it enter year 1400, so it should not be leap year. Fine. So this is my program. Okay. So I think this is the end of the question. Okay. So I hope this is useful for you. So in next video tutorial, in next part 3, I'll be coming with some more important questions discussion. That will be part 3. Till then, stay safe and like and subscribe our channel. Thank you very much.